Exhibit 17 talks about the contract you signed. Did you sign a contract at Bat World?
No.
What contract are you talking about in Exhibit 17?
I thought I had signed it.
Now, that email is dated, in Exhibit 17 is dated August 5th, 2010, correct?
Yes.
And you have been at Bat World in June of 2010, correct?
Yes.
So you wrote that email, Exhibit 17, less than 2 months after you left Bat World.
Yes.
And less than 2 months after you left Bat World, you were telling the board of directors about the Bat World contract that I signed. In fact, you said the Bat World contract I signed said I can't link to Bat World if I don't get a certificate, correct?
I wrote that in the email.
Yes.
Yes.
And you wrote, you were talking about the terms of the contract that you signed in the email less than 2 months after you left Bat World, correct?
Yes.
Now, defendants, excuse me, plaintiff's exhibit number B16, what is that?
This is a copy of a contract.
Is that your signature?
No.
It's dated June 20th, 2010, correct? So it's your testimony, Ms. Cummings, that somebody forged your name to that contract.
Yes.
And it's also your testimony that when you talked about the contract that you signed in an email August 5th, that you were mistaken.
Yes.
You really didn't sign the contract. You just, when you sent that email, you thought you had signed the contract. Has someone presented you with a contract?
Yes.
Who?
Ms. Lana.
Why did you sign it?
The first day I hadn't read it. And then I read it and it seemed really crazy. And then she kept demanding that I sign it.
So it was kind of an issue?
Yes.
You read it, it seemed crazy. And then she kept asking you to sign it?
Every day.
So every day she's asking you to sign the contract and every day you're refusing?
I was very busy when I was there.
And what would you tell her when she would say you need to sign the contract?
I would say I'm busy right now.
And she, you said she kept asking you every day to sign the contract. How many days did she ask you to sign the contract?
Probably 4 days.
4 days in a row?
Yes.
What was crazy about the contract?
Sounds kind of paranoid. That she wanted to control absolutely everything.
Where does it say that?
It doesn't. How it seems to me.
She's maintaining too much control over her interns?
Yes, it seems suspicious.
Specifically what? What in the contract makes you say that?
Why would someone want to have so much control over people who are coming there to help?
And that just seems crazy to you?
Yes.
Okay. Did you tell her you thought that was crazy?
No.
But you thought it was crazy?
Yes.
What happened after 4 days of her telling you to sign the contract and you continually saying I'm busy?
She finally stopped asking.
And you thought you signed it?
I thought I might have at the time.
I mean, when you were there, you thought you might have signed it?
When I went home.
Even though you thought it was crazy?
Yes.
Is this signature different than your signature?
Yes.
Did you sign your name, please? Do you have a photocopier?
Not up here.
Okay.
Yep.
I'd like to photocopy the driver's license. Now, ma'am, I've labeled as exhibit 60, but your signature, you just now signed your name, correct? Can I see your driver's license again? So it's your testimony that your signature on exhibit 60 is like your signature on your driver's license?
I would need to see it inside my file.
Yeah.
Just a moment.
In any event, it's your testimony under oath that the signature on the Bat World contract is a forgery.
Yes.
When you were at Bat World as an intern, did you ever leave cage doors open?
I believe once one zipper may have been open. I don't know who left it open.
And how did red bats wind up flying through the rehab and kitchen area?
I never saw a red bat fly through the rehab and kitchen area.
Were you ever responsible for cage cleaning during the internship?
Yes.
How many times did you clean the cages when you interned?
I cleaned the unreleasable cage once. And I cleaned the baby cages probably, we wiped them down every day, but we didn't throw clean every 2 days.
Let me go back to that contract for a minute. Did you ever tell Ms. Lawler, did you ever express any reservations or criticism of the contract that you thought was crazy that she was asking you to sign?
By then we weren't getting along, so I saw no point in confronting her.
But I mean, when she would ask you during the 4 day period if you, to please sign the contract and you would say, I'm busy, did you ever say anything critical about that contract or express any reservations about that contract?
Not so much.
Who did you say it to?
To Kay Singleton.
Kay Singleton?
I believe it's her last name.
Why did you tell Ms. Lawler you didn't like the contract?
I didn't think anything could be done about it.
What do you mean could be done about it?
I could say I find this contract strange, and she says so.
So you decided, well, I'm just going to continue being an intern here, but I'm not ever going to sign that contract.
Yes.
But you never told her you disagreed with the terms of those contracts, the contract, and that you weren't going to comply with the terms of the contract.
Yeah.